Very good evening, dear parents, teachers, and students, and a very, very great evening to the resource person of the day, Dr. T.P. Shashikumar. We are very fortunate to have such great person of a great caliber for today's webinar. Dr. T.P. Shashikumar is a space scientist, educationalist, spiritual director, motivational speaker and author of Life of Now, Rhythm of Life, Life Made Simple. Dr. Shashikumar was the former Deputy Director, Directorate General of Security, Cabinet Secretariat, Government of India, New Delhi, and former Director, UGC Academy, Academic Staff College, Calicut University, Kerala, and scientist in Advanced Data Processing Research Institute, Hyderabad, Program Planning and Project Management, ISRO HQ, Bangalore, Space Application Center, ISRO, Ahmedabad, and Professor and HOD in Business Administration, AEC, JNTUH, Hyderabad. His qualifications and his resourcefulness was unending, and we are really fortunate. We thank God that we got a chance and a chance to interact with this great personality. Dear sir, a very hearty welcome to St. Teresa School, Harold Colony. It's great to have you on the online platform. And I'm quite sure that all of us, the parents, the teachers, the students, will surely benefit out of this time of webinar. And I wish a great time to all our parents and our students and teachers. Yes, sir, the platform is yours. Wish you the very best, and God bless all that you are going to give for the enlightenment and for the better learning of our students. And also on the whole, I'm quite sure, sir will be giving us good tips to take our life in the right way, as he's also a life mentor, how to look at life and how to go on the life journey smoothly. So all these small tips definitely the sir will be giving. Sir, a very, very hearty and affectionate welcome to you on behalf of the management, staff and students. Now the platform is yours. Please take over. Over to Dr. Shashikumar.
Namaskaram, Sister Rosmin.
Thank you, sir.
I am not with you because of my qualification. By accident, one of my friend took me to your program in which most of you were attending few years back, and then I was in conversation with many of you. So I'm sure that made us to interact previously many times. So glad that I am talking to some of the students, teachers and parents. I am almost every day I am talking to many, but most unfortunate and most disastrous program which I have is when I have only few names on front of me on a computer. It is as good as recording something and sending to somebody else. So,
should we ask them to enable their video, sir?
I am very happy to see faces.
Okay.
Number one.
Okay.
Number two, no tips. How can I make somebody's life smoother unless I know how difficult is their life? Each one should have different solutions. So I don't know how good is your school. I don't know the teachers. I don't know the students. I don't know the parents, most of them here around. Though all around the world I keep on going for lectures, very rarely some school neighboring to my place speak to me. Understood? I keep on talking to teachers from America, England, maybe Gulf, most of the places. Sometime in Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. And because I am a native of Kerala, from Kerala, but hardly I have got some students from Hyderabad who speaks to me. So I wish there are a lot of questions. You could ask me anything, because I believe in the digital scenario, lectures are the most boring thing, because every day you hear too many of the blah 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 from stupid useless fellows. So I don't want to be one among them.
You are.
Yeah, I am one among them. That is what Hemavati, I think she told this. That is what I am doing now. So I am not going to do that, Hemavati, unless you have question. It could be from anybody, starting from principal to the any student who think that they are the most beautiful, they can show their faces. If somebody feels they are ugly and they cannot be shown, Anika has taken a mask. I don't know, you are sitting in a crowd or in a house.
Actually,
this is a beautiful system now. We can put a mask so that nobody knows whether you are crying or whether you are smiling.
Actually, I'm sitting in the office, so actually suddenly I got a message from the principal, so I just rushed in and I leave here.
Yeah.
So, started browsing.
Okay, anybody? You could ask questions. Otherwise, tata bye bye. That's what I do.
We begin with questions, sir.
Yeah. Only questions, not begin. End also with the questions.
Sir, one of the prominent feature nowadays that we see is the students are getting addicted to mobile online games, and during the class hour they are easily bluffing the parents, and if it is both the parents are working, all the more they are free. So this is a constant problem reported by the parents, that my child or my daughter or my son not making use of, they only they are having the gadget with them, but then they are bluffing us. And then both of us are job holders. So how do we solve this problem?
Unless we repair the parents, children cannot be repaired. Number one. Second one, all the teachers must start looking at mobiles. They are the most reluctant people to become digital. I don't know how many of your teachers, having seen Dr. TPS, who is going to come and speak, how many of them know who is this buffalo? Did they do a search? Did they look at the YouTube? Have they done some homework? Any teacher who knows little bit about Dr. TPS?
Teachers, you can speak.
I'll tell you, if I do the same thing to any company who produces a small item in the market, as a selling person, as a marketing person, as a business person, as an accounts person, as an industrialist, they will definitely see who is this fellow who is talking to me to waste 1 hour and 2 hours. But teachers, they are not bothered at all, because they only want to speak. They don't even want to search for new knowledge. So those teachers, when they talk to students, the students also become like that. Actually, what is to be done is, students should get a lot of assignments. Those assignments must be diverting them to do a lot of work on digital and a lot of work on papers. Actually, teachers should stop lecturing. If teachers start teaching, students will start learning. Because classrooms, and especially digital classrooms, have become only teaching classrooms. Learning doesn't happen. Don't think that I am scolding teachers. I am also part of a teacher's profession. And I'll tell you, Sister Rosalind Matthew, what is your designation in your school?
As principal.
I wanted to give you a best certificate which I can give it to any principal in the world where I have seen. That is because behind you, what is there? In the shelf the
files.
Is it files or books?
Yeah, both are there, books and files both.
Yeah, generally when I go to, I must have visited more than 10,000 schools, including CBSE, state syllabus, ICSC, central syllabus, most of the school's principals behind you will see only trophies. I scolded many of the teachers. What are you showing? You are showing that you are great, you got lot of awards. So only you recognize people who get awards. Now let me ask, most of the students, they are addicted to phone. Now I also have a phone, but beside me, there is a 20-second rule in psychology and philosophy. Do you know what is 20-second rule? Seconds is the time span, seconds. If I want to drink water, if there is a flask with water inside which is reachable to me, when I feel thirsty, immediately I will drink water. If I don't have water beside me, I will not drink. After some time, the thirst will go. Your habit of drinking water is because you are keeping water close to you. So always I keep water. And if a 20 seconds distance, as a teacher, as a student, I don't have multiple pens with me, I am not going to write. If I don't have a pad and book with me, I am not going to write down anything. If I don't have books around me, I am not going to read. I don't know how many teachers, how many students, how many parents, they keep scolding, don't see this. But that is always reachable to hand, that distance only. The best method to keep away is keep this phone little far, but keep lot of books nearby. I hardly see students having their own library. I keep saying every mother in their kitchen will have a lot of different masalas. If that is not there, we know in that house there is no cooking at all. So if there are no books in a student's library, that means they are not studying. Otherwise, why I said the teacher should not teach? It's like you are getting parcel from somewhere else and then you are eating. Do you permit that every day to happen? We believe that we are supposed to cook for ourselves and eat, not get a parcel all the time. What are the teachers doing? It's like a parcel supply. You are only giving. You are not even seeing whether they are eating or not. You are dumping it in their dustbin. Instead of that, ask them to prepare. Yesterday, I was talking to one of the BTech. And that BTech engineer wanted to say that, sir, I don't know anything in electronics and communication. Don't ask me small questions also. I don't know. I passed my exam. I am a BTech. But don't ask me anything. I immediately asked a question. Do you want... She has a son of 3-year-old. That 3-year-old son will become 20 years after 17 years. And they will look at your face and say, my mother is a useless BTech. So education, qualification, certificate, 10th class pass, all these are useless, my dear. You want somebody to give 10th class certificate, come to me in 1 month time, I can give that knowledge which gains them to pass their exam. You don't have to teach for 10 years. If they are 15-year-old, they know how to read and write, we can make them to pass exam. So if teachers believe that their job is to make them to pass exams, they have lot of leisure time. So what do? They look at time pass activity on mobile. So instead of that, I will tell you the same syllabus, you look at it, ask few questions to them. Most of them will blink at you with no answer. I was executive director of an engineering college. I was management professor in an engineering college. I gave to Rosmin what card which I had. Until last 2 months back, I was a professor in a university in mathematics department. There are MBA students, master's students, there are teachers. When I ask question, they don't know anything. They just learned something. Now today, very simple. You can make a PowerPoint, make a presentation. Nobody will ask any question. Nobody will even show face in the digital classroom. All these are actually cheating the world. That is what is happening. I'll tell you, when somebody makes upma at home, that upma is not made perfectly well. If there is some defect, you will throw it. You will say, these, you don't know how to cook. But when a teacher teaches somebody and the student is not getting benefit of that, what we will do, we will find fault with the student, but not the teacher. Actually, this is the only business in which producer have no responsibility. After end of the year, we have got an examination, which is also called a test paper. Test examination is used in two field. One is education, second is medical science. When somebody is sick, you go to a doctor, urine examination, blood test, examination, test. These are the two words. In schools also, examination and test, both are used. Only difference is, in hospitals, when doctors see the report, if you have some disease, some problem, some parameters are not perfect, doctor is not going to scold you. Neither the parents will scold children. But in education, if somebody doesn't have a good parameter, the marks are less, immediately you will say, you are not studying, that is the problem. Actually, teachers are like doctors. Their job is to repair them. Unless, if I teach somebody in mathematics, if they don't learn mathematics, I will quit my job. I am not fit to become a mathematics teacher. Decide like that. It is not a second class student goes to third class, therefore second class teachers are perfect. No. I was also teaching LKG teachers, UKG teachers, nursery teachers. It is not difficult to learn. It is not difficult to teach. It is all the attitude which needs to matter. Now today, new education policy, NEP. I gave many lectures around NEP. Many conferences, many seminars. Keep on happening every day. Last 430 days, I am giving lecture. Almost average 2-3 days, hours per day. Most of them are education related. I find this problem not only in one school in AS Rao Nagar. It is there from Himachal Pradesh to Kerala. I travel and then talk to people. Different universities. I find most of them have this problem. That is because from nursery, we will pass them to grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, grade 10. I got one message from, I don't think anybody uses as much as I am using my phone. So if Dr. Osman say that no, people are addicted, I am more addicted than anybody else. Not only mobile, I have got a recorder here, I have got a digital recorder here. I am also screen grabbing this and I spend a lot of time in editing and putting onto YouTube, all that I do. And in between, yesterday what released movie also I have seen. Nothing wrong, but you ask me what happens in the world today, I will be telling. I just finished one recording a program. Morning I was in market. We also do lot of things, right? That doesn't mean you should only study all the time. Now soon after that, 7:15 onwards, I have got another program. In between, whatever I recorded on Chandrayaan, I have to edit and send it to somebody else. So every day there is lot of activities happening. That doesn't mean because you are using phone, you are useless. No, I cannot say that. Not today. 20 years back, I started keeping all the teachers and parents and then students to say, you must go to digital. So nothing wrong. But what is to be done? They must look at what is useful, identify what is useful for them. I am looking at one of the, yesterday, day for yesterday, I think Kerala 10th class result came. And it says 100% pass in many schools, including my own school. I also have got a management, my parents own in school. There are lot of children who wrote, everybody passed. I am sure if I ask some question, they will not be able to answer. 100% pass. Okay. So immediately 1975, one of the Malayalam daily newspaper, one of my teacher has sent it to me. And the news says, there is only 28% people passed in exam. So 1975, that means 40 years back, when somebody writes 10th class exam, only 20%, 28%, 30% people pass. Do you think today's generation has become so intelligent, everybody is learning everything? Huh? Okay, now tell me, I passed my 10th class in 1978. I'm an ISRO scientist. I become director of a university grants commission, director in a university. I was in Prime Minister's office, deputy director in a security center. I was director for a executive director for an engineering college. I was a professor of management, professor of mathematics. Now, anyone here, can you please guess what is my 10th class marks? I'm only seeing somebody, Gautam Dhar, Della Chako, Anika, Hemant Yadav, Lakshmi. Tell me, how much mark? Guess some marks. All of you should guess. Anybody else? Volunteer.
Maybe around 60-70%.
Yeah, anybody else?
95%.
Anybody else?
50%.
I am only 54% or 52%. I don't even remember. And I did not get, that time there was no plus 1, plus 2. It was called pre-degree. Before degree, pre-degree. That's also 2 years program, like 11th and 12th. So pre-degree first year is 11th class. I failed in all exams, including mathematics, chemistry, physics, English. Only one exam I passed, I think it was Malayalam. Second year again I wrote all the examination, somehow I passed. And that pass also is 52 or 54. I don't remember, 10th class 52, then 12th class 54. If it is 54 in the 10th class, 52 in the 12th class. And my brother told me, you cannot study mathematics, you can only study language, that too Malayalam only. Because I used to write poetry, I used to read lot of books, I was reading novels, short stories, I go for movie, I was acting in drama. All that, whatever a child in a village can do, all mischief I did. But then I told, I will show you that I will study mathematics, I will take a PhD in mathematics. Because my professor, my brother was a professor in a college. He said, no, I don't think anybody taught us. We had that challenge. Yes, I am going to study. Nobody can stop me. That's it. You tell anything, that will not work. If the student decides as a challenge, I am going to, then definitely. How to study, how to prepare for exams. Why I am saying, teachers, I wish one teacher from your school contacts me and says, sir, you are coming for a class. These are the problems which you have to want us to from you. I have not seen teachers. No homework is done by teachers. So how can you give homework to your students? You don't care. So they don't care you also. I'll tell you, many parents, many students after this class, I don't know Hyderabad, A.S. Rao Nagar students of yours, how good they are. Many of them, they contact me immediately after 1 hour talk. Many of them will find my telephone number. I remember, I have sent it to Sister Roslyn also, Rosemin also, the Enadu paper. From where? From America. Because Telugu people are settled in America. From Gulf, many countries. Madhya Pradesh, Delhi, Bombay, Chennai, from Hyderabad. Many people contacted me. They want to meet me. That time I was staying in Malkajgiri. I said, on Monday between 10 o'clock to 1 o'clock, you can come and meet me. 25 people were there one day when I just told that I am available for 2 hours. Then I asked them, why did you? Sir, we want to know how to study. I said, you are in which class? 10th class. How many teachers you have seen in your life? Every day they are seeing so many teachers in the schools. Why are you not asking them? Why are you coming to me? They know you better. I don't know you. How can I tell you? How do you study? Sir, we cannot talk to any of these teachers. They don't entertain us. They are very busy. Oh, because I am a free fellow, retired person who has nothing to do, you are coming to me. Teachers are very busy. Teachers are very busy. They don't find time at all. I have got most of my relatives are teachers in my family. That is because we own a school. Most of the, my brother is a teacher. My brother taught me social science. I remember when my brother taught me social science after a few years, when I was in an engineering college in an executive director, one electronics teacher came to me and then said, "Sir, I am your brother's student. Your brother was a great teacher." Evening, I went and told with very happiness to my brother, I found this girl came and told me that you are his teacher and you are a great teacher. Then immediately my brother said, "It may not be about me. I was never a good teacher," he said. See, you should have that clarity to say, "I am not a good teacher," so that you can improve. Don't think that why Dr. TPS is telling like this. I must have taught more than 5 million teachers. That was professionally my job. Plus, I went around teaching many, many people. Rosmin knows. Sister Rosmin met me when I was talking to all the principals of your school streams, right? When? 10 years back almost. That's my everyday job. So I'll tell you, teachers, you want students not to get addicted to anything. They should get addicted to learning. I must get an answer after 1 month or 2 months when any teacher comes and says, "Sir, because of your lecture, I made my students addicted to learning." Will you be able to say that? Take all the teachers an oath. Yes, you can do that. How? Identify at least 10 good students. I will gift them at least 500 rupees book each, one of them in their house. I will send from my money. I don't know how much Rosmin is going to pay. I don't think, I never asked money also to anybody. So far, Dr. TPS has not taken any money from anybody for any lectures. I told Rosmin also, I don't want money. I will send from my pocket if there is a student who wants to learn. I did it. Many places I did it. I am not joking. But only I will give books. I will give one book first. And after 1 month, I will ask few questions. If they can answer from that book, I will give another 10 books. How many teachers will take this challenge? From your salary, how much money you have given to some student saying that it's a wonderful student. I have got one bright student, so I am gifting this. Anyway, this is your job. Identify any teacher who has done it. Any student can tell, "Yes, this teacher told me like this. Today I am giving 10,000 rupees as a gift to that teacher who told this." Show the face of any teacher who have a guts to say, "Yes, I have one student to whom I have given books like this." This is what I am saying. We are only selling education. We are only doing time pass job. We have only complaints about students. And why they have become like this? The parents will say, "See, my child is not studying." I heard many times telling this. Immediately I will ask, "Show me your house. Do you have a bookshelf in your house?" If you don't have bookshelf in your house, no. You cannot expect that your son will have bookshelf. Now, I am sitting beside the same table is used by my son also. When I look at, I have got a bunch of books which cannot be handled in my hand. An equal number of books are there for my son also on the same desk. So keep books. Then your addictions will go. This is my answer. Yeah. Lakshmi is showing hand. Welcome, Lakshmi. You can interrupt. Yeah.
What I feel is like what we do in front of our children, they are going to do the same thing.
That is what I'm saying.
This, like I learned this like 2 months back. Since we use mobile phones in front of our children, even they are addicted to it. So what I started is during college days, I used to study a book at night. Every day, I used to, let it be any book, storybook or whatever it is, I'll study, then I'll go to bed. So I started that habit again. So 2 months, what I did is, in front of my children, I started reading books. So they were in a, they were like, okay, mom, tell me this, what you are reading, what is this? They started asking. And my son, no, when he got first rank in the class test, no, he told me, ma'am, mom, can you buy me a book and give? So what I felt was, okay, this must be the right step. Like whatever we do in front of the children, we are going to follow that. So like parents know when they do something good in front of them, when they read some books, even the children will start reading it. That's what I felt. I'm sorry to interrupt, sir.
No, sorry at all, Lakshmi. You are a teacher or a parent?
Teacher in St. Teresa, sir.
Okay. So you have your own children studying in St. Teresa's or some other school?
Some other school, sir.
Okay. Which class they are into?
Elder one is in 5th class, younger one is in 1st class.
I'll tell you, when I was doing my college, I had a Sanskrit professor, K.H. Subramaniam. He has only a 2-room house, one room and one bedroom, kitchen, small house, rented house, because he is from somewhere else, came as a professor in our college. I used to go in the evening and then sit beside him. Because those days I love a lot of slokas. So my hobby was walking from my house until I reach their house. I will study one and then tell him, this is what I studied today. He was never teaching me in my class. But I heard him teaching in some other class. So I got love towards his class. So I wanted to get a dialogue with him. When I went there was a small partition board. Partition board is like a screen on a frame. That is what partitions is hall and the kitchen dining table. There is no dining table. Kitchen, dining table, hall, everything is one and the same. There is only a small partition. And on the wall, there are a lot of paper sticking. Every day newspaper sticked in different style. Politics, one column. Another column, sports. Another column. And his son was a small boy. Now today he is an IAS in Kerala, that boy. Every day when the son was small, young, he used to ask the boy, cut this paper, paste it. It was all English newspaper. The boy cannot even read. But I am sure if you keep doing it for a month, the son will ask you, or without asking, he will identify which is sports section, which is cinema section, which is chief minister, who is chief minister. That is how you should teach. Why I am saying this to Lakshmi, most of the parents may not be readers. I was teaching in some remote villages also. I used to go to Northeast. If you ask them to read a newspaper, in their life they have never seen a newspaper. There are such places also in India also. You are all in the city, so you may not know that. Don't go too far. You go to, the last week I was there in Bongir, behind that someplace. The student whom I taught MBA and he got a pass mark, today he is only on the palm tree to get a toddy. That is his job. So don't think education gives you a job. I used to tell people that the students know you should read newspaper. I don't think he has ever seen an English newspaper. No, why English newspaper? Not even a Telugu newspaper reaches his village. You go, there are such people. So I'm sure that is not required. You get some old newspaper, kg 3 rupees. Ask them to cut and then separate. That's a great knowledge. You understood? Reading is not books. Reading is not story books. Reading newspaper is current affairs. That becomes general knowledge. That becomes English learning. And every child by birth is eager to know. Every small child will ask, what is this, 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 what is this? Anything which they see around, they keep grabbing. It is only parents and teachers, after some time they will say, let it be anything, how does it matter to you, don't disturb me. If they can stop telling this and answering continuously, or if you cannot answer, 9447437948, that's my number. Anytime, I'm sure there are a lot of people who are eager to know. By birth, all of us are eager to know. But it's parents who stop them. Got it? So, nothing wrong. Mobile phone is one of the best option where you have a spelling you don't know. Search www.wordhippo.com. That's the best dictionary. Don't look for the meaning. Read the whole meaning. That is reading. That's good enough. You need not have books. So I am saying the same mobile phone where you get addicted can be converted into a good purpose. Otherwise, what is doing is time pass. Keep on looking at different things, right? That's a problem. So probably they parents may not have, but I am sure parents can make these children to read stories for you. My mother was illiterate actually. My father, I never have seen my father in my life. I lost my father when I was 4 years old, not in my memory. But when I was a small child, my mother used to tell by heart the whole story and then tell me. She will not even stand and listen. She will be doing work. I have to go behind here and give the story. Somewhere if I get stuck, she will say, go and read. So it's not that she could read or she made me to read. That's the difference. So parents, give assignments. Children should be 200% busy. That's what every teacher and parent should keep on giving assignments. And answers should be sought. If you tell tomorrow morning 4 o'clock, tomorrow morning 11 o'clock, I want answer. 11 o'clock water fashion, it should come. Not 11:01. What we lose is punctuality. What we lose is discipline. And no patience. If you don't have patience of sitting and reading and writing, they don't even patience for sitting in exam hall. Most of the children fail because they don't have patience sitting in exam hall for 2 hours, 3 hours. That's a problem. When you apply for an MNC company, your 10th class mathematics only they will ask. But that 10th class mathematics in the normal examination to answer, you have half an hour. A tough question, maybe 10 minutes for 3 marks or 2 marks. The same question with a 1 mark in an MNC company, you will answer in 1 minute. So your 10 minutes has to become 1 minute. So you must be very fast. How do you become faster? Practice. Practice, 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 practice. There is no other substitute. When Arjuna was taught by Krishna, Arjuna said, I am not able to follow anything. I am not able to understand anything. I don't know what are you saying. Immediately Krishna said, Abhyasena tu Kaunteya. Keep on practicing, my son. That's it. Nothing else. Keep on practicing. That's it. So I have got 30 points to students, 20 points to parents and teachers. That's what Sister Rosmin wanted. You want the tips. All tips I wrote maybe how many years back? 17 years back. It's there on my blog. 30 points to students, 20 points to parents and teachers. I don't tell any prescription for students alone, not parents, not teachers. Because my name is Doctor, Doctorate is in Mathematics, TPS. Teachers, parents and students. That's my name.
Wonderful, wonderful name.
Okay. So I guess all teachers and all parents should start making their children to do keep on. How do you make somebody to practice for dance? Practice many times. How do you make some singers? Practice many times. How do you make them singers? Swimming. Cycle riding, one time ride is not good enough. You will have to ride many times. So if you want to be a good student, only one method, practice. That's it, no other substitute. You will start loving. And if you are a good teacher, I'll tell you, every teacher has to be a marketing person of their own subject. You are not teaching them, you are only marketing. If somebody comes to me and say that mathematics is difficult, give me one day. I will make that student to love mathematics. If somebody, I have got students. I'll tell you, I've got a student who was in 9th class. She came to me and said, every subject is good, sir. My Hindi is very bad. I said, those days I used to conduct a camp for children. I said, next week, 10 days camp in Kerala. That's my house. Come, stay there. Sir, which Hindi book? I said, no books at all. First, you should love Hindi. Then you will search for Hindi book. To create love for the Hindi, you don't require. That book is boring. The teacher is boring. When I start reading the book, immediately your teacher's face will come. And all the scolding what the teacher give. No. No books at all. You just come without a book. We will write books. We will write poetry. You know what did I do? Amitabh Bachchan's beautiful movie. Amitabh Bachchan's beautiful poetry. कोशिश करने वालों के हार नहीं होते यार. कोशिश करने वालों से हार नहीं होते. What do? They keep on trying and they get it. That's a beautiful. If you have not heard that song, कोशिश करने वालों, right? Amitabh Bachchan. He is singing his father's poetry. What a beautiful song. Every word, you don't even have to explain. It's understood inside itself. The theme has to be understood. And soon after the camp, that was in December, January, there was a test. She got passed 60%. The Hindi teacher called, what malpractice you have done? Where did you get this mark? Because she is 100% sure the student is going to fail and all automatically passed. Couldn't believe. So it's all your love towards the subject which make you to. So every teacher, your job is to make your students to love that subject. That's it. Once they start loving, you don't have to teach. They will learn themselves. There are better teachers than any one of you. Internet. Why do you want to teach? I'll tell you. Last year, this is the time when Gulf students have got holidays. So last year, because of COVID, I did not had my camp. So many students who used to attend, they told me they wanted a virtual camp. So I conducted a camp called Moksha. In which a drama, all the different activity, that's how they become communicators. You conduct a drama in English, many people will participate, they will know how to speak dialogues. So you become communicator. That's called a dramatics. There are methods for teaching language in different style. Whichever language they want to learn, they can have a drama in that. So one of the student, my criteria for selection was from 8th grade onwards up to 12th grade students can participate. So one of my student who attended my camp physically in Kerala, she said, I am only in 7th class, but I don't want to miss your camp. I also want to join. I said, come. I'll tell you even today. Yesterday also I got a question. Physics, maths, chemistry, environment science. Then what? Some English question. Few questions. She will make it into a word format and send me. Sir, when are you going to give me time? We want to discuss these problems. So I will make a Google Meet. Call all the people who are in my contact. I have got 100 people who wanted to learn. I will send all of them. At least morning I send it 1 hour. 10 people will join. And those 10 people will listen. I will edit that and post it into my YouTube also. You can see Rishika. Her name is Rishika. She is from Abu Dhabi. 7th class passed, now 8th class. So many questions she will ask. How many of your students have got questions and doubts? If your students have questions and doubts, that means your student is a good student. And you are a wonderful teacher. If they don't ask you questions, that means you are a useless teacher. If they are not asking questions, that means you are not increasing their curiosity to learn. A teacher's job is not to teach and give answers. It's served in the textbook. Anybody can read. Anybody who can read English, all subjects can be read. What are extra things you are doing as a teacher? When I was a student, I used to ask, when I started studying, I did not leave my teachers free. I keep on asking questions, and many teachers cannot even ask answers in the classroom. When I used to be in hostel, when I was doing my post graduation, night they will come and knock. Now only I got the answer. So evening onwards, they are working on my problem what I give. We don't ask questions which is available in textbook. You like tough questions. So I love students. That's why when Sister Rosmin asked to start with the question, I wanted to end with the question where I cannot answer. Then I will tell your school is one of the best schools. It's a challenge. Let anybody ask question which I cannot answer. Let anybody ask a question which I will have to work and then come back to you. I'll tell, yeah, I don't have answer. I will come back to you later and answer you. If such students are there, they are bright students. If you don't have students, those would have questions. You are pouring water in a vessel where it will not hold anything. Whatever you teach, whatever you tell is useless. I am active, I am live. That's why I am showing. I wanted to stop, otherwise I keep on talking. That's my problem. I am a good speaker.
On the side of the parents, someone could ask the doubts for parents. Or the students, I think many students are present. Classes 9 and 10.
There are 74 people. You imagine, there are 74 young people. I am sure if they are attending from their home, their parents are also there. There are many teachers, as you said. At least 20 teachers are there, say. 50 students are there. They should learn from the teachers how to ask questions. That is what you should teach. So if teachers are asking a lot of questions, that means, yeah, you know how to ask questions. Therefore, just now Lakshmi said, what you do is what your students will learn. Otherwise, you can, any teacher can introduce. I will start asking questions. I have got a lot of questions which are answered, unanswered. I wanted to test whether teachers are really bright or not.
Good afternoon, sir. I am a 9th standard Kiran, my mother.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll tell her to read the books. From the, when she got the means knowledge, I tell her to read the books. Books only is your friend. Till now, she'll not read the books only, sir. I'll tell her to read the books.
Okay.
Which give you more knowledge and you can understand the good and bad.
Yeah.
So, even though now also I'll tell her, she's very poor in English now. So, if you have read the books, you would have helped out in the subject also and you would have get the knowledge. So, she will not at all listen to you. And now she's in the 9th standard. I'm making her to get up in the morning. Even though teachers and the principal madam, I'm really very thankful to the principal madam and the teachers who are guiding, like, very, means they're taking care of a lot, even though online classes. They're not at all very serious at studies.
Kiran Mai is a girl or a boy?
She is a girl, sir.
Girl.
She is a girl.
Ask her to go and sit in 7th class from next year onwards. Again, okay. Start from fresh.
Okay, sir. Definitely. Because
number one. Second one, if that is, she doesn't want academically punishment, don't give her lunch, dinner until she finish one chapter and write on a paper 3 times and then get back home.
Okay, sir.
Otherwise, close the door and put her outside. Go wherever she wants.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Huh?
Because, see, we are educators, we are helping her out.
No, I'll tell you, Kiran Mai, don't read anything for reading purpose. Just because your mother says don't read.
Yes, correct, sir.
I will ask Kiran Mai, she is there now or not?
She is there, sir. She
come on to video, ma. What is this? Are you so ugly? Your children are so ugly. I am handsome, that's why I am showing my face. Wherever I go, I will put on my video first.
Yeah, sure, sir.
Yeah.
On the video.
Where do you stay?
On the video.
Kiran Mai, where do you stay?
Yeah, 1 second.
Where are you staying, Kiran Mai?
We are staying, but see, answer the question to this.
Good evening, good afternoon, sir.
Where are you staying, Kiran Mai? Rampalli is too far, na?
Yes, sir.
Why are you coming to AS Ravnagar from Rampalli?
For studying.
You are not studying, that's what your mother says. So why can't you go to some government school nearby? Huh? Okay, which subject, which chapter you don't like, you tell me. Which subject, which chapter you don't like?
Math.
Which chapter?
Trigonometry.
Who is teaching you trigonometry?
Ranganai Kiri
sir. Is that teacher is around here? Okay.
Okay, teacher.
Okay, tell me. In trigonometry, why? Trigonometry is for triangle.
Yes, sir.
In a triangle, when two sides are given, the other side you can identify easily. Fine.
Yes, sir.
But what is trigonometry? When angle is given, one side is given, everything can be told about the triangle. Did your maths class started with a circle and drawing with the sine, cos, reversing it and all that?
Yes, sir.
Do the trigonometry class with a circle or a triangle?
Triangle.
It should start with a circle. Because it's only angle. Angle comes in circle, 360 degree. Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
When you take a radius and from zero you put 360 degree, it becomes a circle. You know how to draw circle, right?
Yes, sir.
Now take a pen and paper, and not now, soon after the class, draw a circle like this. Now this is your base and this is your vertical height. What you draw between the base and the height is called a hypotenuse. This is your height, this is your base. What you draw is hypotenuse. Correct?
Yes, sir.
And in a circle, the base becomes height, height becomes base, because you are rotating it like this. Is there a difference between the base and height actually when you draw a circle?
No, sir.
It is one and the same. But in a triangle, you have a base and a height and a hypotenuse in right angled triangle. When you think about circle, it is all one line which goes like this. So therefore, what is the difference? When it is 90 degree, one value. When it is 0, another value. So sine 0, 0. Sine 90, another value. Sine 45, another value. So you are actually demonstrating the circle like this. Now, if you want exactly to understand, I will speak to Kiran Mayi. Kiran Mayi will teach me trigonometry. After one day or 2 days, you talk to me Monday morning. You can skip your class, attendance, no problem. Or after the class, you come and talk to me. You must read that whole chapter and you must be able to teach somebody else. Are you ready, Kiran Mayi?
Yes, sir.
You must teach me. Your job is to teach and discuss with me. I will ask you questions. Are you ready for that?
Yes, sir.
And then you will become a person where you will look at the trigonometry and then tell that, ask me anything, I will tell you what the answer is. It's a beautiful subject. One of the most, I don't know whether, you can look at Dr. TPS trigonometry in YouTube. There may be one class from me. I'm sure there will be some class, because most of the classes I record and then post it. So you understood what I'm saying? This is the base, this is the height, this is 45 degree. When 45 degree is there, the base and the height become same. 1 and root 2. Therefore, cos and sine will become same. Sine 1 by root 2, cos 1 by root 2 for 45 degree. Sine become 1, and cos becomes 0 because it's just reverse. You draw one circle, take the half of the circle and reverse it and put it down. So you will get an S like this. That is where sine and cos is different. You want to know where is it used? If you don't study this, whole calculus is gone. Trigonometry depends on calculus. Trigonometry depends on any mathematics in any engineering subject. I was teaching BSc mathematics students calculus analysis. Look at how many times I am using the word trigonometry, triangle, cos, sine. So anywhere after 10th you wanted to study something, without a trigonometry you cannot live. I am from space department. We have got satellite going. How do I know what height the satellite is? You think I can go and measure?
No, sir.
How do I do? You know what do we do? We take a small telescope and look at it where the... See, when the satellite goes up, my camera has to tilt right. When it is on the ground, my camera is like this. I am looking from here. This is the camera. But when the satellite goes up, I will keep on tilting. So how much I am tilting, the angle I measure, and where I have started shooting it up, it will tell you where the height is. So the base and angle is given, height can be measured. Is it not trigonometry?
Yes, sir.
So do you think some space scientist can live without knowing trigonometry?
No, no, sir.
What a beautiful subject, yeah. How can you hate trigonometry? You take your hand, keep it on my head. Your head. Ayyoh, na janma ayipoyindi enne. Without knowing trigonometry, my life is lost. You must tell that every time. Otherwise, Kiran Mai, soon after 10th class, do something, somehow 18 years, ask your mother to get you married to some auto driver, some coolie fellow, some vegetable vendor, some driver, and then live with them like that. And you also produce another Kiran Mai second generation. Put them into same school where some of your junior teachers will become principal there, like Sister Rosemary is sitting, somebody else will sit. They will also teach. You will also complain about your children.
No, sir.
Yeah, that can be done. Easily that can be done. You decide what you want. You want to study? See, I'll tell you, Kiran Mai, when I was studying, trigonometry was only in 11th and 12th class.
Yes, sir.
My book was too big. And I was from a Malayalam medium, went to English medium. The teachers were teaching. It took 3 months for me to identify which chapter the teacher is teaching. I did not even know that is trigonometry. To identify the subject and the chapter. Now Kiran Mai is a beautiful, wonderful, brilliant young girl. I was a useless, ugly, not at all good, bad student who cannot show my face to anybody. Because I didn't know which chapter the teacher is teaching. Now you could tell trigonometry, I don't know. I was in a confusion, which subject, which chapter, chapter heading also I don't know. So who is better? You are better or I am better? So if I can become a scientist, what you can become?
Doctor.
You want to become a doctor and kill all the people or what? Without knowing. And don't think, I'll tell you, if somebody believes I don't have to know mathematics to learn and become a doctor, only biology is enough. I will tell you another subject. I went to one of the medical colleges to teach. I am also a psychotherapist, so I learned biochemistry, I learned many subjects. Many doctors will come and talk to me. I went to one of the medical college to teach. There were only MBBS students. But then when I went back home, I got a WhatsApp group in which my name was added. All of them are doctors. I said, what are you doing? I am doing MD, MS. What do you want? Sir, we want one day mathematics class. Because all the doctors after MBBS to become MD, MS, all the higher studies in doctor, they have one paper called research methodology that is full of mathematics and statistics. And most of them forgot their mathematics because they thought I don't require mathematics, only biology to become a doctor. Little chemistry is good enough. Not at all enough. You know, when you go to a doctor, you will see the ECG. ECG is a graph. Graph is mathematics. You use lot of scanning machine. The scanned report is mathematics, scanning machine is physics. Physics is full of mathematics. So if Kiran Mai think you can become a doctor without mathematics, I'll give you a shapa, you will never become. Should I give a shapa and finish?
No, sir.
Or you may become a doctor, but you will never get a patients. What is the purpose of becoming a doctor without a patients? And that time also you will look at all the patients. I had some doctor came to me and then talking about the problems. Then I said, if patients will come to you, they will look at your face and, doctor, what happened to you? Why are you crying? They will ask. And you will have to say, yeah, I am not able to understand this graph because I did not learn maths in my life. Then the patient will tell you, better go and learn some mathematics from some teachers. Doctor, you are unfit. So without mathematics, you cannot learn better. No way. Mathematics is the language of science. Physics, maths, chemistry, biology, everything with mathematics only. Once you know mathematics, you can learn all other subjects also. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, do you like trigonometry or not?
Yes, sir, I like.
Finished. My job is over.
Sir, thank you very much, sir. Now she is not able to scared about the math. She used to scared.
Who
about
is
the
this
math.
Mother? What is her name?
Sir?
What is your mother's name?
Lalita.
Ask her to keep her hand on your head. And say, my daughter is a good girl.
He is a good girl, sir.
No, my daughter is a good girl. Kiran Mai is a good girl. Tell everything 100 times.
Yes, sir.
And what Kiran Mai should do is buy an A3 paper, big paper, chart paper.
Okay, sir.
And all the bad words, bad things your mother will tell, everything you write in different beautiful color. Paste it in every room, wherever you go. And ask your mother, keep quiet. I am reading everything, everywhere I am reading. You don't waste your time from now onwards.
I will not call her, sir. Just I will guide her. I will not scold.
Now assume she wanted to say that you are a good girl. Ask her to cut all this and write, Kiran Mai, my girl is a good girl. She is my daughter. I love her so much. Keep on asking her to write that. Ask her, don't waste time by scolding. Instead of that, cook and beautiful biryani and then feed you. Don't waste my time. You tell like that.
Definitely, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, Principal Madam, and thank you, teachers.
And read my 30 points to, and look at how to prepare for examination. In some school, I must have given lecture. 30 points to students, 20 points to parents. I am explaining there. Look at the YouTube and down you give a comment so that I know. Yeah, Kiran Mai has seen. From this school, so many teachers, so many students have seen. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Now, if you teach trigonometry one chapter to me, I will give you many of my gifts will come to you.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Finished. Trigonometry is over.
Someone else from the students?
Sir, this is Anisha's mother, Poonima here.
Anika or Anusha?
This is Poonima, Anisha's mother.
Anisha?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you are also a teacher?
No.
Huh.
I'm a parent.
Okay, what do you do?
I'm working in a company as AGM.
Okay. Where?
In Hyderabad, Dazzle Sportswear in Kompally.
Kompally, okay.
My daughter always have problem. It's not even a problem, I can say. The thing is, she says like I study, but the next, whenever I go into the next lessons or next chapters or any subject,
she forgets
about the last.
She is there or not?
Anisha, she is there.
Ask
Anisha,
her.
Yes.
She's actually attending from home.
Yeah. Anisha is there. Where is Anisha?
Yes, sir.
Open your curtain, yeah? You are behind the curtain.
Anisha.
Anisha, what you should do is, I'll give a trick of learning. Where is Anisha? She left again. Yeah, she's there. She came close to you. My display keeps changing, right? So tell me one chapter from which subject you don't like or which you like. Any choice is yours.
I like chemistry. Okay, subject.
One chapter from that chemistry. Which class you are in? 10th or 9th?
9th class.
Tell me one chapter.
Language of chemistry.
Language of chemistry. You look at the heading. What is the heading of the chapter?
Language of chemistry.
100% sure. Now close the book. Take a notebook. Not now. Soon after the session is over. Take a notepaper. Without looking into the book, write everything what is there in the textbook. How much you can write? Will you be able to write 10%? 20%? At least all the technical terms will come or not? 30% you can write? 40% you can write? I am sure you cannot write 100%, right? Don't look at the book. Just write the content. Every paragraph, different paragraphs are there. Each paragraph, the content, maybe 10 sentences are there. Can you write one sentence, two sentences by paragraph?
Yes.
After that, keep the notebook away. Read the book again. Why are you reading now? After some time, I must be able to close the book and write. If I could write 20% now, I should make it 40% after 1 hour, 2 hours. So my purpose of reading is to reproduce it in the way it is there in the textbook. I will tell you, Anisha, if you can do this up to 10th class, at least 60% perfection, guaranteed you can write Indian Civil Service and become IAS. Because that is the ability every best officer in this world who serves India wants. They will have big files. They must be read that. They must be able to brief their boss. Oh, this is what the content of the... This is called English comprehension in English language. But most of the teachers think this is only a English job. It is not an English job. This is actually the teaching methodology. How to learn different subjects. When you read a paragraph, how much knowledge you can capture. That test Anisha has to do yourself. This ability, if you can improve in your life, every subject, that is your own testing. Nobody need to test. If you can do that, finished. Now what you should do is, take the chapter, look at it. How much tough questions you can make. How difficult questions you can make and gift to your friend. Who is your best friend, Anisha? You have problem.
My best friend is Vaishnavi.
Gift to Vaishnavi every week. From every subject, every chapter, difficult questions. And I am sure she will also give you a return gift. All the difficult questions she will prepare and she will give it to you. Both Anisha and Vaishnavi will become the best students in few months. Your problem of they don't remember things will not stay. Your problem is they know everything in the subject will be your problem next. If you don't write, if you don't make questions, now when your friend gives you question, your job is without looking into the textbook, you will have to write an answer and gift it to her. And when you get answer sheet from your friend, take a red ink pen, do whole correction, find out full mistakes. How can you find mistakes if you don't remember the textbook? So your job will be searching for mistakes. How many times you must be reading now? Once you read again, second time you read to see that it is complete, you can write down. Third, you read to create a question. Fourth, when you are evaluating the answer sheets for the answers written by your friend, you are again ready. 3-4 times you read. When you get a question paper for exam, you will say, oh, this question, I made it and gave it to my friend. Oh, this question, already she gave it to me and I answered 3 times. Understood? That's the best way to learn. You will enjoy. You will enjoy not as a student, you will enjoy as a teacher. So don't 8th, 9th, 10th class teachers are all useless. You should become your teacher. You should become teacher of your friend. And when you are not able to do it, when teachers must be supervising this. Oh, are my students doing it? How many of them created how many questions? And all such difficult questions which are not there in any question bank. All the teachers can collect this and print a book next year. You can become authors in your own subject. Teachers will become guide writers. And all the best answers written by your students, just type it and print it. And today everybody is digitally doing it. Collect all of them. Your school can publish guides for the next batch. Who created this? 2021 batch, 10th class, 9th class created guide book for each subject. Very simple. Your problems are all simple. I don't have any problem which I cannot solve. And if you have any problem, you are not able to understand, you are not able to reproduce what you wrote, some sentence is not able to understand, look at the dictionary immediately. Every word by word, each chapter, all technical terms, write down. Search for technical terms. Language of chemistry, introduction to chemistry, there will be a lot of, different words. Take all the words and write down, look at the dictionary, understand the meaning. If you can understand the meaning, not learning. Learning is different. Don't learn. Understand. Understand. Understanding is in your manas. By heart. Learn by heart. If your heart is there. If your heart is given to somebody else, 8th class, 9th class girls and boys, they will share their heart. In the heart, it somebody else is filled. You are no maths, no physics, nothing will go inside. So you are heart should be full of, don't learn by buddhi. You don't require buddhi. Heart, love towards subject. Otherwise, hate subject. Now Kiran Mai was hating. Now she became lover of trigonometry. Earlier she was not showing her face. Now she is in video. You see the smiling face. I don't think Kiran Mai's smiling face was seen by her mother also. Ask her to look at my smiling face. I am happy now, you tell. Give your address. I will send you. I don't know whether Swiggy gives you food there or not. I will give you parcel at your house. Don't worry. You see? That should be the method. And after writing first and second time, you compare your notes and you see, is this what I wrote and is this what the textbook has got? Is this what I wrote now? Finished. Done?
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the suggestions you have given.
Sir?
How to get an interest in history? History is one of the best subjects, Amma. I teach people for civil service. Without history, no pass any exam. I've got a book on civil service handbook. Look at my book. How to prepare for civil service. All my books are here. Look at all Dr. TPS books. And you can download, it's all free, not for sale. Yeah, civil service handbook. How do you prepare history? Beautiful. I was just looking at how do I speak of Chandrayaan. Immediately, 1999, Indian Academy of Science decided they are going to launch a satellite. 2000, Astronomical Society decided you can go ahead. 2003, Prime Minister spoke on August 15th that we will launch a satellite. How am I remembering all these dates and years? History is mathematics. History is mathematics. You draw a line, zero here. This is BC, this is AD. all negative lines and positive, BC and AD. I am a person who took birth in BC. What is BC? Before computers. And you are all children who took birth in AD. What is AD? After digital. What is ABCD? History is ABCD. AD and BC. Everything in AD is in BC. Everything is in BC is in AD. And if you know ABCD, you know history. Beautiful, no? Don't you know ABCD? Don't you know history? So you have a chapter. What you should do? Draw a line. Your history learning should be different now. When you learn history, draw a line. Write all different years coming in the history book and write what happened there. It becomes a beautiful graph in front of you. Each chapter will become a graph. So look at the graph, the whole history you can speak. And how do you remember dates? Always I make a joke. 1964 I took birth. That's the year when Nehru died. 1984 I joined for MSc. Indira Gandhi died. 1990 I got a job. Rajiv Gandhi died. You understood how am I remembering?
Just go and study the years.
2009 I retired. That's the time Manmohan Singh came second term. 5 years, 2014 he left. And beautiful song, all the prime minister's names. Prime Minister Dr. TPS. Beautiful song I wrote. My children during camp, I write poetry, tune themselves and then sing. And you want to know all the, not now, earlier before partition, all the districts of Andhra Pradesh. I made a song. Tirupadi unnadu chitturilo. I wrote a beautiful poetry. So all the district names becomes a poetry. Chemistry, you want to learn all the elements. Beautiful songs are the nursery rhyme songs. So songs will make you to read. Presidents of India, Dr. TPS, you look at it, Presidents of India, and who are all the Prime Minister in between when these people were presidents. Beautiful graph. So what you should do, history should be converted into graph, chart paper. One chapter, one chart, one page, finished. And when you read history, understand the geography. No history without a place. So when somebody says Daulatabad, Daulatabad is Aurangabad. Aurangabad, Aurangzeb came. Aurangzeb came, that's why Aurangabad. Hyderabad, Hyder came here, that's why Hyderabad. From where did he came? Look at that place, draw a map. So take India's picture, draw from where people coming. How did they come? Which year they came? Write it down, finished. What a beautiful subject, yeah, history. If you don't know history, your life is mystery. Now tell me which subject. I love history. Without history, no civil service, no general knowledge. First question, when, what, where, why happened. The other day I was, civics also is asked. The other day I was teaching one of my students who is preparing for IAS, how to learn Indian Constitution. Class is there. Dr. TPS, Indian Constitution. Then you will see my social science classes. Yeah.
Sir, yeah. I am fear of maths.
Can you give me your mobile number? 944-7437-948. Otherwise, type Dr. TPS. I told you, teachers, parents, students. Temperature, pressure, second. Top police service. Thermal power station. That is TPS. Just search Dr. TPS. Otherwise, if you don't even remember that, today's date, how do I remember today's date, you know? 21-07-17. 21-07-July-17. 21-07-17. You search on YouTube after a few days, same class you will see on my YouTube. So I remember this is the day when I went here. This is how I did. Yeah.
Sir,
Sir?
Yes.
I'm not able to complete my works in a punctuality way.
That is because you are busier than Prime Minister of India. So
if
many jobs.
To complete in a punctual way, I mean, if I think to complete in this time,
yeah.
I am not able to complete in that.
Very good. Don't think when are you going to complete. So whenever you complete, you decide. This is the time I decided, so I complete it. Why do you want to complete a job here? Where are you completing job? Only start the job, study maximum, finish it. You have still time to go. Don't become too much of a timetable where you cannot follow. So your timetable setting has to change. Don't sit for 1 hour. Half an hour will you sit together and then study, Sai?
No, sir.
How much time you will sit at a stretch to study, you tell me.
Maximum half an hour.
Yeah.
An hour.
Don't sit even half an hour. 10-15 minutes. You have seen every TV program after 5 minutes, 10 minutes, there is a break, right?
Yes, sir.
You have a sister at home, right?
No, sir.
Who has? Mother, father, brother, sister, somebody is there at home?
Brothers.
Yeah. What you do is after 15 minutes you study. What is your brother studying?
He's studying 6th class.
Yeah. Both of you decide. We will study for half an hour. After half an hour, what you should do? You say that we will come and meet together, start hitting each other, do all the mischief what you can do, and 5 minutes play, and then tell 5 minutes over, our break is over. Now we will go back 20 minutes study. In between, you take break. Otherwise, you are not productive. You are sitting long time, but concentration is not there. Sraddhavan labhate jnanam. Those who have got Sraddha, they can only learn. Sraddha, Sraddha, concentration, concentration. If you have concentration, you take less time. If you have no concentration, you take longer time. So without break, don't study. After a break, what you did before going for the break? Again, think again. Completing is not important. Understanding is important. And you have lot of time. Your schedule, your time has to be decided by you. Okay. You make your schedule, decide that what you want to do. And have sufficient time to play, have sufficient time for fun, have sufficient time for helping. Which class you are into, Sai?
Ninth, sir.
How can you make pudina chutney? Gongura pickle, how do you make?
Donna, sir.
Yeah, you are busy. Help your mother learn some cooking, spend some time in the kitchen. All that is essential. Your maths, physics, chemistry will not help you. Other day I got gongura from somewhere. I don't know how to make gongura. I never made. But somebody gave leaf first time in my life. So what should I do? I made. And immediately the person who gave me leaf also had sent me YouTube video. This is how you should make. Then I told him I already made. I sent him picture. Immediately he was asking me, how did you make it? It is looking much better than the traditional one. You should learn everything, yeah. In your age, 7th class, I used to cook at my house. Clean your house, cook your house. All this is exercise. Help your mother. Ask your mother, tomorrow Sunday, holiday for you. I am going to take kitchen charge. Go out. Learn. Don't think that, no, I don't have time. I am too busy every time studying 365 days, 24 hours. What is this study? Are you Prime Minister of India or what? So much busy in your life. So much scheduled time. Kya hai? Are you a mission or what? Relax. But enjoy. Enjoy study, enjoy learning. Don't keep head in line. Which class?
Ninth
class, Appo. Then what do you do when do you PhD and all that? When you go to Masters, B.Tech, M.Tech, what are you going to do? If you are going to put your hand down like this, you will have to put your hand inside your head then. Three holes here and three holes here. And I'm not able to study. What is this life? Enjoy. It's all simple. Every subject is simple. Now you ask Kiranmayi, she will teach you how to learn trigonometry. Similarly, you decide, I am going to learn this subject tomorrow and teach somebody else. Your schedule will work. Because tomorrow you have to teach somebody else. Otherwise, you will keep on postponing. You want to finish, you are on time bound. What is the time bound? I am going to study this chapter, my friend is going to study this chapter. After 1 hour, we are going to exchange question paper. How much time you have? And whatever answer sheet your friend is writing and giving to you, don't evaluate it now. When you get real sleep, you start evaluating. When you are evaluating, correcting your friend's answer sheet, will you get sleep? What a beautiful idea. They will give you in blue color, black color. Tomorrow you are going to show everything in red. Full mistakes and then throw at their face. Full mistakes, you are not written correct. You will enjoy midnight to 12 o'clock, you will be correcting answer sheets. Do it. I enjoyed not in 9th, 10th class. 11th also I failed. But 12th class, this is the trick I used. That's why I passed. All my BSc, this is what I did. But then I made beautiful question paper gifted to my teachers. Take this from me. This is a gift from me. You answer if you can. Tough questions to teachers. Answer if you can. Shanmukh Sai.
Yes, sir.
Show your smiling face, yeah.
Sir, my video is on, sir.
Yeah, but smile. Light is not coming because teeth is showing, then only light will come.
Light will show.
Yeah. What's your father, mother doing?
My mother is a housewife. My father is a computer hardware.
Yeah, hardware man. That is why hard. Life is hard because hardware. Software means it would have been very soft. Yeah. Enjoy. You must learn hardware. First thing what you should learn is whatever your father knows, you must learn first. Whatever your mother knows, you must learn that also. That's why I asked you. Cooking you should learn, hardware also you should learn. All these maths, physics, anywhere, anytime you can learn. But what your father and mother is doing, when you live together only you can do. After 10th, 11th, 12th finished engineering, you are never at home. You play football or what?
Yes.
Yeah. Eh?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I know you play football. Looking at your chahara, I can say. Good. Play nicely. Enjoy. Yeah.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
I'm Satvik's mother from St. Teresa's School.
Okay.
She's studying in 9th class. So, this COVID, the teachers are giving good guidelines to the students. And they are giving good efficiency also.
Very good.
To the students.
Yeah.
But my son, Satvik, he is the online classes are going in phone only. So, every period I should ask whether you are in the class or not. Because he is having such knowledge, but he is not using his knowledge. He is only just laziness and he is keeping his headphones to the head. And whether he is in the class or not, we are not getting any information. But my son is having good knowledge. He can study, but he is showing his laziness. That's all. So, can you give any suggestions to my son?
See, Satvik is keeping headphone on the head only, right? Where else he has to keep it? Headphone is to keep on head only. What is the problem?
He is not attending, or whether he is attending the class or not, we are not getting any information.
See, Amma, what is your name? What is your name?
My name is Jayashree.
When you are making chapati or dosha, are you using tawa?
Yeah.
If your husband or somebody else come and tell, don't do like this, do like this, don't put your tawa here first, why are you not putting tawa here? Keep on telling you, will you get angry or not?
Of course, we will get angry. But
so, leave it to your son, who is matured. Has he started getting mustache?
No, he is still, he did not get anything.
So, he is a small boy still, that is the problem. You make him a big boy first. Consider him. Don't look at Satvik as a small boy you have. Satvik is going to get married in another 10 years. He will have another children in another 15 years. He will start earning money and serving you food. Don't consider Satvik as a small boy. Keep on going behind him like a small boy learning to walk. Let him study if he is interested. If he is not interested, let him go to hell.
But parents cannot leave like
that. That is what I am saying. The biggest problem is parents are like when you are making dosha, somebody is keep on telling, do this, do this, do this. They get irritated because you don't have any other job. The problem is parents are lazy, they don't have any job, they don't do anything. Go out and do some work, keep your house clean, do some good job, make some beautiful biryani. Not only to him, to his friends also you give. Ask them to come to house, have a combined study. Ask them to go to somebody's house, eat there. You prepare beautiful food. If nobody is eating, you come, tell me where your house is, I will come there and then eat. Don't involve in unnecessary things, they will become disturbance. After some time, if you don't tell, they will not even go for one or two.
Okay.
Give some freedom. You consider them little higher, 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 higher. Don't go like an LKG, UKG. They are in 9th class, 10th class, they are independent. They must have that responsibility. Yeah, I must study. I will not tell this when I am talking to 6th class, 3rd class, 4th class children's parents. That time you need to orient them. 8th class onwards, you know the new education policy. Do you know a new education policy? What government says? If a 9th class boy don't want to study, they can stop studies and go for whatever they want.
He is having such knowledge.
Very good.
But he is facing laziness.
That is not a problem. See, because he, same thing, if suppose you are cleaning the dining table and immediately your husband will come and say clean again. First time when you clean, you don't feel like cleaning because anyway after he comes, I will have to clean again. Nah?
Okay.
So 3 times, 4 times, same thing. Why should you read? How many books you have at your house? You show me your library. Not your study books, other general books. Do you have Vivekananda's biography?
I am saying,
ask him to read as much as he can. Don't keep on telling him to study what small things. Give him big job. And what you should have is, you should also have sufficient time to read much more so that your son will see, oh, my mother is reading, I should also read. You understood? Instead of telling him what to read, what not to read, you are not concentrating, you are not reading, that should become a activity inside your house. Father, mother, brother, everybody should have discussions, different reading, different subjects. So Satvik may be very bright and brilliant. That may be one problem. So such people, once they read, they know. So they will feel, I don't require. That's why earlier I was telling, ask him to prepare question, gift it to friend, look at the textbook, read once, ask him to write again. Not just reading. Without writing, reading is useless. Without writing, reading is useless. Both has to go in tandem. Yeah. So every time, what you should do is ask him to prepare a question paper, give it to the friend. Ask them to prepare a question paper, ask him to write. Ask them to copy the same paragraph, same way. Keep on preparing notes. And then read general books, as many books as he can. Because you have books at home, your husband is also learned lawyer. I am sure there should be a lot of books. So yeah, he must know all the articles.
Yeah.
CPR he must know. Criminal procedure court you must know. Civil procedure code you must know. All the tort also he should know. Evidence Act let him know. Everything let him know. Then he will feel, yeah, I have got much more to learn. Similarly, maths, physics, chemistry, biology. There are beautiful videos where MIT professor, Cambridge professor, how are they teaching? So look at all the different great lectures, all TEDx lecture, all the documentaries. You don't even have to read biography of Vivekananda. Biography picture is there, Vivekananda. But after seeing the picture, you must be able to make a beautiful note. So create a beautiful note of different biography of all the great people in this world. I've got a book. The book's name is called Makers of India. What's the book name? makers of India. What does it say? All the great personalities of India. I think I don't have it here. It's in my ground floor. Great personalities of India. Write down at least 15 great politicians, 15 pre-independent people, 15 spiritual people, 15 richest people, 15 best advocates. Okay, who is the Advocate General of India?
Advocate General of India. Who is the Advocate General of India?
You understood what I'm asking? Such questions should come. Read Hindu newspaper, world page. Lot of international rules will come.
Justice.
Yes, should, question should come. Question should come.
Okay, general of,
you understood what I'm saying? Question should come. Lot of such questions. Your Satyaki should have 100 questions. When you meet a politician, so many questions should be there. When you meet a sports person, so many questions to sports person. When you meet a cinema active person, lot of cinema questions should be there. All rounder. Then he will enjoy life. Okay, don't complain. Keep hand on the head and say, you are my good boy. You are my loving boy. You are smart. He will become alright. See, I was not a good boy. If I am something today, it is just because my mother kept on telling, tomorrow you will become a good boy. Always she will say. She never said you are bad. But indirectly, it means you are bad. You understood? Two ways of telling. You are not a good boy is a negative sentence. Instead of that, what she used to tell? Tomorrow my son will become a good boy. Every time. Tomorrow my son will become a good boy. Some mistake is done. Tomorrow he will become a good boy. Keep on telling like that. So they will get feel confidence. Yeah, I am going to be good tomorrow.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Enjoy.
Thank
enjoy. You. Smart boy.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, I am unable to overcome many subjects, sir.
Unable to?
Overcome many subjects.
30 points to students, 20 points to parents and teachers. Just follow all the points. Done. Some of the points what I explained now. Preparing questions, serving it to somebody else. These are all one point in that. Okay? Yeah, Yashwant had something.
And I am tougher in maths.
Practice. Prepare questions, sit with your friend. If you don't understand, ask them. Ask teachers, get some questions. Take a lot of problems and keep on practicing. That's the best thing. Yeah, Yashwant, they had something.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. All the best of it. Yeah.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, I'm Yashwant from class 10.
Yeah.
Sir, I feel that I don't like...
Your sound is breaking, so I couldn't get which subject. Biology.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, best method. All that what I told, same method is applicable for every subject. Look at technical terms. I am 100% sure biology technical terms like scientific names and all very difficult to remember. So what you should do is identify, make a table by yourself. This item, this is the name. Technical terms, beautiful table explanation. Keep on creating for every chapter one table. All technical terms, all difficult terminologies, if you know, biology is easy. If you don't know, difficult. And look at dictionary to understand meaning. Each terminology, look at the dictionary. It will tell you explanation. Look at Google, Wikipedia. All the explanations you write down by yourself. Until you understand, repeat it. You will do good.
Thank you, sir.
All the best.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
I am Jaya Maudhuri.
Yeah.
A parent of KVS Gautam of 10th.
Yeah.
He is here, you can see, Gautam.
Yeah.
I just have a query, sir. It's just my doubt what is running in my mind every time when he does it.
Yeah.
Actually, they are in 10th now. I think if they read the textbook, it's more than enough for them to learn.
Mm.
So, do they have to maintain on notes and then keep killing time by writing it?
They have to, otherwise what happens, most of the problem is how to reproduce in the exam hall. If you don't have practice of writing, oh, I know this. But I know this is not enough. If you understood perfectly, then only you can write. And writing paragraph wise, in the textbook it is paragraph wise. Most of the answer sheets are so ugly to see, they don't know how to separate a paragraph. That's why I said paragraph wise. When
can you suggest,
yeah,
can you please suggest the best method of keeping on notes so that it is effective?
That is what, when you have one paragraph, when you read one paragraph, you must be able to write at least two sentences. So when you write, read a page, you have at least 5 to 10 sentences with you. Depends on number of paragraphs. The whole chapter is read, you have one page note with you. When you look at the one page you have written, that's called a brief. If you can make a brief of your textbook, then you don't even have to go back to textbook. When you look at the brief, you know, oh, this is what the textbook says. If you don't have an explanation for that, refer back to the textbook.
Thank you so much, sir. But the best method, what they are finding and they are practicing is refer from the guide or Google and then write the answer.
No, that is not the worst thing, because I will tell you, all the guides, all the Google, they are not done by professionals. Textbook, there is a textbook committee. I was also part of it once upon a time. When we write each chapter, each paragraph, how is it related to the next one? All this is thought by different intelligent people. Guides are only some buffalo copied question answer, which have no relation with second question answer, does not have a relation with the other one. So you can learn and get marks, but you don't understand. That's why I am using the word learning is different, understanding is different. Learning is a brain process. As soon as the exam is over, you will forget it. You ask any subject from any place, I am able to tell, because I have not written any exam for this. But I have been discussing with a lot of students, lot of teachers, different subject at different point of time for last 10-15 years. So every subject content I understand. Then I am using my logic. Got it? Say I go barehanded for most of my lectures. When somebody asks me 10 questions in a paper, I don't even have time to look at it. I am now 6 o'clock, I am finishing. 7:15, I have an interview. I am interviewing one of the journalists who wrote about me in Indian Express. That when a Enadu fellow read about it, they copied and they came and interviewed me. That is what came in Enadu. Search Dr. TPS Enadu, send me a WhatsApp, I'll send you that. And that person who wrote about me, I am interviewing today. And that sort of people I am continuing for next 1 month. Today is journalist. Tomorrow I am interviewing the Texas State IT chief, who is serving in the government there. I am interviewing tomorrow. So today journalist, tomorrow Texas, day after tomorrow yogi, Yogacharya. So next philosophy professor. I am interviewing different people in different streams. How am I able to do that? See, you should have that ability to understand. Understand one subject, it is related to most of the subjects. Understand one chapter, it is related to most of the chapters. Otherwise in a guide, what will happen? First chapter, second chapter, third chapter is not related to in the guide. So you are constructing first floor, second floor without a ground floor at all. It will collapse. Your children will get good marks. They will get admission in engineering college. But engineering college, India performance is 4%. Out of 100 people, 4 people are only passing.
True, sir. I truly agree with you, sir. I need a clarification from this, because as you said, parents, I always put on my hand on him and then say, you are my best.
What do you do, Srihari? Your name is Srihari. Are your name is Srihari? Or?
No, sir. My husband's name is Srihari. My name is Jaya Madhuri. I work as a teacher. So I believe in what you said. So even we say kids also, like, you are the best. So even though they think they are not the best, but they try to prove, yes, they are the best.
I will tell you, the biggest enemy in education is guide. Second is tuition teachers. because they also, I don't think anybody needs to rub the same thing to clean many times. You will only have to use a smart liquid for cleaning solution to clean it faster. So if you are smart, you don't require anybody to rub it many times. So once you read, it's good enough. But that reading should be smart. Smart work is important. Okay, Gautam, you got what I'm saying?
Okay.
Where do you stay, Gautam?
Okay.
Where do you stay? Where do you stay, Gautam?
Sir, I'll record you.
Where do you stay?
Speak loud. Speak once again. Speak, Gautam.
Okay. See, you have a good name, Gautam. If you get enlightenment, you will become Buddha. Other day I was talking about Buddha in a yoga program. Last 1 month was full yoga talk. So I was talking about, you type Buddha, Dr. TPS, you will see what I spoke about Buddha. Even if you get everything passed, when you go for IAS, they will ask questions on Buddha only, because your name happened to be Buddha. You understood? That's how it is not what you learn from the textbook what is asked. What general knowledge, how are you going to analyze? That is how they look at it. My book, Rhythm of Life, another beautiful poetry book in which I wrote about Buddha. Buddha cannot be the 10th avatar because he left his wife. Krishna and Rama did not leave them. They were prefixed in their names. Sita Rama, Radha Krishna. So Gautam cannot be a reincarnation of the 10th avatar of Vishnu. Some Tibetan people believe that Gautam is, Buddha is the 10th avatar. So I contradict that in my poetry. So Gautam reminds me of my old poem which I wrote 10 years back. Rhythm of Life, that's my book name. It's a beautiful book. Every teacher will love this because it's like a beautiful cartoons. It's all can be downloaded. Rhythm of Life. Beautiful format. Nice pictures. Okay. Yeah. Good enough.
Thank you so much, sir. So I would request from now he would invest his time completely in reading the textbook and then
textbook. Yeah, for exam paper, identifying the tough questions, probable question for examination. Yeah, maybe instead of looking at lot of question papers, such books will help you.
Thank you so much, sir.
God bless you. So Gautam, 9447437948. Any problem? If you don't understand, refer.
Sir, can you please repeat the number?
9447437948.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Understanding the subject more compared in the in group, I mean in class. If you don't mind, can you tell me the tips to make students learn in group also? This all that what I said is preparing questions, sending it to somebody else. Today you cannot sit together, but you can always share questions and then ask them to challenge. Right. Correct. So group study, you don't have to sit together and study, because I'll tell you, each one of us have got a different capacity to understand. So when you sit together and study, somebody will feel I could understand, but others could not. But if you have a doubt to ask, you always go to peer groups who are students who are studying with you. You can ask them. They will explain you much better than a teacher can explain, because they know the frequency level. If I explain, probably some student will understand, not the other student, because everybody has got a different pattern of learning. So I wrote a book, it's a question which was there in the chat box. I wrote a book called Adaptive Learning. This is my book on education, in which different methodology styles of teaching is explained. Inductive, deductive, one of the method is discovery. So every student has got different style. So some students, why I was telling you don't have to spend this, with the question I know what sort of style they have. So they need a lot of things to read. Don't spend too much time. But for somebody else, when I asked, they said, you should repeat and do it. Exactly contradicting answer I gave. Because when the question comes, I know that what sort of a student is that. So it's not applicable for everybody. So one student will feel like repeating many times. Another student, once they read, they understand. Second time when they ask somebody to read, they get irritated because I already know. So their style of learning is different. So, but the same student can explain this to the student who don't understand. Actually, both of them will get benefited. There is only, if I have got 10 rupees, I will give the 10 rupees to somebody. They will get 10 rupees. If their 10 rupees is given to me, I will get 10 rupees, they lose 10 rupees. But education, if I give what I know to somebody else, I get double and they get triple. So sharing knowledge will always increase your knowledge. So always keep giving knowledge. I will tell you, most of my classmates who were students with me in graduation still have contact with me. Their children also is contacting me for learning. Imagine your own colleagues, children come to you to learn. Why? Because annadanam param danam, the best danam is giving food. That is not correct. Vidyadanam atatparam, higher than that is giving knowledge. Annena chanika triptihi, when you give food for some time, it will get satisfied. Yavat jivam javidyaya, when you give knowledge, it will stay for lifelong. I am sure whoever attended this actively cannot forget Dr. TPS. They will still remember 2107-17 in their life. Oh, there was somebody who taught like this. That taught me how to learn. So I am not teaching maths, physics, chemistry, biology. I am only teaching learn to learn. I only teach one. Learn to learn. How to learn is what I teach. So what method I use for Kiranmayi is different. What method I use for Gautam is different. What method I use for Ishwant is different. For each one of them, it is different. But in a class, teachers cannot do that. But when group study, you can identify, oh, this boy want one more explanation. So let me explain. So when friends explain, there is no ego. They don't feel ashamed. So best thing is, what you learn, teach somebody else. Then you become the master of that subject. That's what I did in my life. So when I was studying, I was not good. But when I started teaching my colleagues, I became very good. I was not good in English at all. So what did I do? I started teaching grammar. How do I teach grammar? When somebody gives me a verb, I must be able to tell all the 12 tenses. I take, I am taking, I have taken, I have been taking, I took, I was taking, I had taken, I had been taking, I shall take, I shall be taking, I shall have taken. Like this I know. When somebody asks me the meaning, immediately I will tell all the meanings. Not one meaning. Dictionary, whatever meaning is there, those times we have only limited dictionary. That's how I brushed up my English. So if you don't know something, invest more time. So everyone has got some liking, some hatred towards some subject. Sit together. Mix them together, so you will start loving every subject. Yeah, one last thing I want to ask. There are many, many lasts. Yeah, lastest last. Yeah. How to lose the addiction of playing games? I also play beta. Soon after my dinner, my wife will say, one board game, please. So we will sit and play. But we will say one board game. After that, we will study. After that, let me do my job. Addiction is, you decide. That's why I told you. 20 second reachability. If water is close to me, I will drink. So now you don't want to play board game, take it and keep it in some corner. Which game you don't want, keep it in the upstairs. Gift it to somebody else. Finished. You know you don't want, that is the best method. That's all. And you want, you keep a ration. Controlled, 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 controlled. In a beautiful movie, one of our best actors from Kerala is Mammootty. YSR movie also he was acting. There is a dialogue from him. Every parent should make their children to fly like a kite. Allow them to fly as high as they can. But keep a rope. If the rope is not there, what will happen? The kite will flow. And somewhere else it will hit with somebody else and that will fall. You are in danger. But don't allow them to keep in a shelf and then say, I have a kite, it is in my shelf. The kite is useless. So playing is necessary, eating is necessary, cleaning is necessary, cooking is necessary, every job. I love movies. The day the movie is released, I like to see that. I write lot of reviews on movies. Who is the best actor in Indian cinema? The legend. Tell me. Amitabh Bachchan, right? I was with Amitabh Bachchan in Muscat. I started movies in Muscat. I am also into movies. Today one movie producer called me. So, movie is good, game is good, sports is good, everything is good. Drama is good, poetry is good, singing is good, dancing is good, everything is good. Cooking is also good. Look at how to prepare chai, Dr. TPS. How to prepare tea also. You have little science in that. Okay. So you must make something different. You create your own method. Good enough. Sister Rosmin did not expect this much, I am sure. You thought I will give 1 hour lecture. I will give 1 hour lecture and go away. No, it will not work.
Very, very thankful. So I invite our teacher, Mrs. Pushpalata, to say a few words of gratitude.
I must tell my love and thank you for all the kids and parents who asked me questions.
Yeah.
If you are not showing face and asking questions, I would have been useless. So if at all I have proved a little better, all of you raise your hands. Take it back and say well done, well done, well done. So if I have done well, it is not me who has done well, because you asked reasonable good questions. Okay? Namaskaram, pranams to each
one. Very, very, very alive and vibrant with your...
That's all what we can do in our life.
Yeah, different way of looking at things.
All my books are hidden is L-I-F-E, life. Live in full enjoyment. Learn in full enjoyment. Learning is an investment for future earning. So many expansions of life I keep on writing. Right?
Your knowledge and experience is limitless.
That is because I keep meeting lot of limitless people. Now today I meet lot of people. I already got at least 3-4 WhatsApp messages from your schools. And some people, what they will do, they will record and then send. They don't want to type because they want to speak paragraphs and paragraphs. So all that I answer. Some people cannot write English. So what do I do? Yeah. They write in Telugu. So what do? That written Telugu, I will take a translate, understand in English, and then write in English, translate in Telugu, and post back. Imagine how much patience I have. And I get thousands per day. Not one or two. And I have got my own group who are all attending regularly with my lectures, following me, listening. Lot of people are there. He keep on doing. I'm also into agriculture. You look at agriculture, Dr. TPS. You can see a lot of webinars, talks. So it's interesting.
An amazing personality. So
understand. You were there. You were there on the day when from your place where we stayed, I was going to Aurangabad. You were there.
Yeah. I was that time. I was not here in Hyderabad. I was in Vijayawada.
Yeah. That's why you were in Vijayawada, but I came to Aurangabad.
Yeah.
Aurangabad. We had a lot of fun. 3 days, 4 days, I go and stay in their school, and then all the teachers, students, parents, everybody I will finish. 3 days, continuous.
We wanted to have actually a physical seminar, but then not possible.
I am only 3.5-4.5 kilometers away from you. Either Malkajgiri or Tirumalagiri. Two places I stay.
Yeah, that's what our students, parents and teachers can always...
always get in touch with me. Yeah.
Yeah. So here we have teacher Pushpalata to propose...
Good evening, everybody. Let me be a little bit formal, sir. And I am Pushpalata, teaching faculty of St. Teresa High School. I deem it a great and extremely privileged to propose this vote of thanks to our resource person, Dr. TPS Sashikumar Garu. Sir, you've been, what attracted me most is the life mentor that's been given there. You have not confined your subject just to one thing, but you have not confined your teaching to one subject. I feel you have taken the whole stack of life, and that is really inspiring. And I have a quote here. I would like to quote. It is a beautiful thing when a career and a passion come together. I unquote. So I extend my heartfelt gratitude to our resource person, sir, to you. As long as you were talking, one thing in my mind was running. The picture of, the movie that went on in my mind. Two movies were running in my mind actually, which I really loved and watched them many times. One is Three Idiots, where students are made to enjoy learning. And another one is Sarism in Pay, where dyslexic students are being addressed. And something that is very emotional. And this really mentoring youth to...
Pushpalada?
Yes, sir.
In that Three Idiots movie,
yes, sir.
Amir Khan's professor was my close friend. So I gifted my book to where he was studying films. I gifted my poetry book in which first poetry is millions of sperm from the father get into the mother's egg and only one sperm take birth and that's me. The same poetry is quoted in that movie. That is from Dr. TPS poetry.
That's really great to know about that, sir. I'm sure definitely people like you must have been into that, making of that. And I admire movies while teaching. Even when I was teaching smaller classes, I once remember teaching them. I teach history, I teach social sciences, and when I was teaching the metropolitan cities for fifth class, I think, I just gave them that song. Chiranjeevi is the best song. Yamaha Nagar, Kalakatta Puri. The whole, I got a tape recorder into the classroom. I just played the song many times, and the same thing, same topics were mentioned in the textbook. That time it was state syllabus which I was dealing with. And now I feel making learning, enjoying, it's a relevance to life that we need to be bringing children into to help them to really love learning. And basic ground floor, as you said, basic roots are very, very important for a child. If the child has that experience of loving to learn, definitely they would become a great personalities. And the best thing that your aim, what I feel is, like enrich their skills towards nation building. We all have to build a nation. Definitely these children, if their dreams are enriched, they will definitely be a big source of strength to the nation, what I feel is. And I also like to thank you because as a parent too, I have learned many things. My own daughter, my daughter is aspiring for civils for next year, and she is started her coaching, that too online. And your books and free online downloads will definitely help me, I hope. Personally, I would like to thank you very, very much for giving us I have no words, sir. I'm falling short of words extremely because we are very, very fortunate to have you this evening to really enrich us, to all the parents, teachers, and just to rejuvenate or rethink on what we are doing as a passion or no. So I'm sure your expertise has educated us, enthused us, and definitely has geared us to take up learning to the next level, to the students, to reach the students. We are really privileged to have you this evening, sir. Thank you so much. And on behalf of the management, on behalf of teachers, on behalf of the parents, and on behalf of the students, definitely I would like to fold my hands, and I would like to appreciate your expertise and your thank you for sparing your valuable, most valuable time with us.
Thank you, Sister Rosmin. Thank you, Pushpalada, for these nice words. Thank you, all the parents. In 1 hour, I have to go on what India needs. That is the discussion which I am going to have. Those who want to join, just send me a WhatsApp on my number. I will send you the link. From 7:15 onwards, almost every day we have got.
I will send it to our teachers, sir.
Yeah, I have already sent to Sister Rosmin.
Yeah, you have sent to me. I will send to you.
Bye bye. God bless you. God bless you.
Since you are very busy, I don't want to take your time. But I only just thank you from the depth of my heart. for accepting and for enlightening all our students, parents and teachers, and we look forward for more sessions with you.
Take care of your health, take care well.
Okay.
Enjoy as much as you can.
Thank you, sir.
God bless you.
Thank you, my dear.
Thank you, dear.
Thank you, sir. Sir, I gave a message to you, sir.
I have answered most of the messages. I got at least 10-15 of them. When the Thanksgiving was going, it goes because I do all shortcut. I don't have to type everything. It's all shortcut, so it goes answers fast. Okay? Bye-bye. See you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
God bless all your undertakings and all your responsibilities.
Pranams.